Hi guys, it's me again, and this is Uno Numero Uno. And today, here with me, I have a really good friend of mine. He's actually one of the top graphic designers that I know. Pretty lousy at FIFA, but he's really good at his job. Matt Achar, karibu man.
Karibu sana.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Achar, yeah. You've been designing for one of the top clubs in town.
Yeah.
So my question is, like, how did you end up being a graphic designer and designing for these clubs that you design for?
So designing, it started back, well, when I was a kid, I had this drive and wanting to be like, to do something creative, more like designing or just playing with clay. So it was just there, the talent was there, but I didn't channel it, I didn't focus on it because I had so many things going on, high school and everything, adolescence. But then it got to a point where I can say around 2011, when you're trying to discover yourself, what you want to do. For example, like you're trying to figure out what you want to do in campus or anything.
Yeah.
So I moved out from home, so I went to my own place, and I didn't know anyone from school. So in your first year, how it is.
Yeah.
And then I was just me and my laptop, and still knowing a few people as I continue my first year.
Yeah.
And then as I was doing the coursework, I used to go to school, then use the Wi-Fi, and then go back home. So in school, as I was using Wi-Fi, I was just like curious about how some designs are done, maybe like posters. They're just these creative pictures you see online.
Yeah.
So I was just so creative. I was so curious about that. But then I didn't know how to do it. I didn't know what software to use or anything.
Mm.
So once I saw there was a YouTube channel, there was some Zungu there who posted a picture and explaining how he designed it and everything.
Yeah.
And then I got curious, so I just asked a question, which software did you use? So he told me I used...
You asked them Zungu?
Yeah, I asked them Zungu.
Okay.
So he replied back, I think after like a day or two. And then he just wrote, I used Photoshop CS2.
Okay.
So I was like, what's a CS2, what's CS2? So I went on Google, searched it, and there was some few pictures on it, so I had to download the software.
Yeah,
I just started practicing. So it was hard. It was so hard, but practice after practice, watching tutorials.
Mm.
So it was more like the talent was there, but it was just hidden. Mm. So I was just using some few tools to bring it out because I was enjoying as I was learning.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So that's how it started. That's how it all started.
What's the first thing that you ever designed, or how did you? Like, we put a client in Ghana, the first client that you got.
Since I was still in campus, the first client was just some rowdy guys. You know, back in campus where guys have plots and stuff.
Mm.
So actually then there was this movie that came out called Project X. I'm sure you've seen it. Yeah.
Okay.
So Project X was just a hype movie, guys throwing wild bashes. So these guys from campus, like 3 years, they were like, hey, so you design us. You know how to do it. So I just took the computer and I just started designing. So me, I was like designing, I was like, it doesn't look that good. But to present, Kuonyesha, I was like, they were amazed. Like, what?
Ah.
So yeah, that's the first thing I just saw. So from there, guys were like looking at the design and they were, you know, kuchocha, just hyping it.
Yeah.
So word spread that they know how to design for people. So it went on like that till I was given like, The first major gig of a design that I did was Mr. and Miss Jaguars. Yeah,
the first official one that you did.
Yeah, that's the first official one that I did. That was big for me.
What's the edge you have, like, over others? Who is Sema? What your stronghold? Nini exactly?
What stronghold I have?
Yeah, that imefanya upate such good contracts with the likes of Kina, Tribeca, and Natives.
I usually stick to detail. Detail. Like, for example, when I do a poster, I really look at the detail. Because me, on a most competitors, I'm just people that I know designing, they miss out on small details.
Okay.
Of which your detail makes the whole concept. Which, you might not see it, but it speaks a lot on your images.
So what edge I can, like, that's one of the things that I can use, edge. I look at the details, and then also image quality.
Yeah.
I usually use high pixel images.
Definition.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then something else that I also use is, what do you call this? Reality pictures. I don't know if you understand. Like, reality pictures, what I mean is...
pictures that look real.
Yeah, okay, definitely pictures that look real.
Yeah.
But I'm just saying pictures that... You see, people put pictures like look sort of cartoonish, animated.
Yeah.
Like the alcohol there, the whiskey, doesn't look... So I usually just pick real pictures. I might take them myself, and then I use them there. So I usually like to put real stuff so people can look like this is something that exists.
Mm.
I use it. So that's something that I tend to... also put there on my posters.
Yeah.
And then I not only do posters, I also do logos, business cards, magazine adverts, newspaper adverts, social media adverts,
yeah.
Almost anything to do with design.
With design.
So, yeah, so what I do, I use less of words and more of images. So I use images to bring out the message.
Because pictures speaks.
Yeah, pictures speaks more than words. Because the way Kenyans are, people don't like to read.
Yeah, true.
So if you write something, then a lot to read more. So if you just put a picture that speaks out a message, then that's good.
Yeah. So what are the challenges that you're going to face now with this job?
Challenges?
Yeah.
Challenges that I face is mostly to do with clients.
Clients
come in many. You are going to sana. So you are overwhelmed with work. So you know, one of the challenges. You do like 5 jobs, then kuna 6-7 na come. So, and then they are still trusted clients. So kwa turn down in ngumu. So you delay some work. So yeah, that's the clients coming in. Unafanga wengi, so it's a challenge.
Mm.
Another challenge is how do you put it? Time. Time in the sense that I usually have my own things to do. I have my own photography thing to do. I have my own social life and everything.
Yeah.
So unapata, let's say I'm out drinking, I'm eating food with some people, I laugh, a client calls you. Atio, I want this design done. ASAP, I have to give you money. So you're like, hey, so you know, a bit of a challenge, you know, gamble. It's like, so what you're going to send out to the money, but you're going to find along the way, you've just lost some part of yourself, so it's kind of a challenging thing. Then, something also challenging is some clients tend to rob you of your payment. But if I'm a client, then I'm not going to pay. I have clients who have just deposited a lot of money of mine. So, you know, one challenge. Yeah. So, I'm going to pay. I'm legit and I'm going to pay. This is how we do it. I'll pay you this much. I'm going to agree, you do it. So we call contact for your pesa. Inakuwa challenge. So una pata sasa ngine unasahau ama yeah. So it's a bit of a challenge. Yeah.
Always because I've encountered such people in business.
Hey, lazima. It's there. Whichever business you're doing.
Yeah.
There's usually someone who will just support you in terms of money. I'm just con you or some sort.
Okay.
Yeah.
So and okay, as we conclude, what I'd like to give you like 30 seconds to just say where people can reach you to kind of advertise yourself and also give advice to the people who would want to do what you're doing.
So you can reach me at Achar Designs both on Instagram and Facebook, and I'm also working on a website coming soon, so check it out. So just look up Achar Designs, you're gonna find it on the Google. So you're gonna see my work. So if you want some of the designs done for you, you can just check them out. Logos and all sorts. Oh, yeah. What advice can I give? It's challenging, it's hard, it's not easy. Then it needs a lot of patience. Tana, once this kind of work, you need it plenty. Because you might even do designing or learn designing for 1.5 years without being paid. What you're paid is like 200 shillings. So the patience is just what bears fruit in the end. So that's what I can give advice to anyone trying.
Well, there you have it, guys. You heard it from Achar Designs himself. You have to put in work to get the results that you want. Don't be brainless. Just think and work. Subscribe and comment if you want. Just do something. Don't do nothing, okay? There we have